Hello lovely dancers, my name is Aisha and welcome back to Belly Dance Tutorials. In today's class I'm going to do an introduction to Arabic rhythms that are used in most of the belly dance songs. Before I start, I would like to thank you all for subscribing to my channel. Thank you so much for 500 subscribers so far on this educational channel that I started last year in March, so close to 2 years now. I hope you enjoyed my tutorials, I hope you find them useful. I have a lot of fun doing them, I really love doing it, and I hope you'll continue watching my tutorials. In today's class I want to do an introduction to some of the Arabic rhythms that are used in belly dance songs. It's just an introduction, so I'm not gonna go over all of them and I'm not gonna go over a lot of details, technical details, metrics, time signatures or so on. I'll just describe them in terms of dums and teks and give you some examples from real songs. So let's get started. First of all, I would like to go over the sounds from a drum. So the basic sounds that a drummer does using his drum or tabla are dum, tek and ka. Ka is a soft tek. Dum is the heavy downbeat sound. Tek is more high pitch and is more crisp. And then ka is a softer sound. Some people call it tek as well. And ka is used doing touching or slapping the drum with this finger or these two fingers, while tek is usually using this part of the hand, so several fingers. And dum is by slapping the drum with the whole hand. Other than the sounds, we also have pauses or rest, a pause or a rest. So in between the sounds, these three major basic sounds, we have pauses. So in general the rhythm is anchored by the dums. So the most important sound in a specific rhythm is the placement of the dums, but also the pauses. The teks are sometimes embellished, and instead of a tek, the drummer may play a roll or several teks or a ka and the tek and so on. So there are so many embellishments that the drummers do. But the dums usually are clear. It's very rarely that they would skip a dum or replace it with something else. So if you pay attention to where the dums are located in a musical phrase, they'll help you a lot to identify the rhythm. Now, why is it important for us dancers to know the rhythms? Well, it will help us craft our choreography. And it will help us come up with the correct movement, the correct styling for the rhythm that's played. We cannot just randomly do any kind of movements on any kind of songs or any kind of rhythms, even though sometimes we may do so. But in general, we want to respect the character of the song, the character of the rhythm, and acknowledge that and not let it go missed. I am not a trained musician, I am not a drummer, although I do play the drum once in a while. I'm a dancer, and I will present that from the perspective of the dancer. So let's get started with the most commonly used rhythms. And I'll start with Malfouf. Malfouf is usually an entrance rhythm, and it sounds like this: Dum-Tek Tek Dum-Tek Tek Dum-Tek Tek Dum-Tek Tek Dum-Tek Tek Dum-Tek Tek. And it's a fast rhythm. And I will actually divide the rhythms into those that start with one dum and those that start with two dums, two or more, two or three dums. So I'll start with the family that start with one dum, and I already described the Malfouf rhythm, dum tek tek, yes. And I will play a couple of segments from songs just to illustrate that. Dum-tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek. Let's move on to another one. Dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek, dum-tek, tek. Sometimes they are embellished a lot, so you hear a lot of other sounds than these basic ones. And let's, I'll give you an example from a real song. And the rhythm is a little bit more clear here. Tek tek dum 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 tek tek. The next fast rhythm is Ayoub. And that's kind of similar to Malfouf, and it sounds like that. Dum ka dum ka dum ka dum ka dum ka dum tek dum ka dum tek dum ka dum tek. And this is sometimes played slow. It's used for what we call a zar, and it goes like this. Dum ka dum tek dum ka dum tek dum ka dum tek dum ka dum tek. And we use the hair movement for that. Or sometimes it's played fast and it's good for an entrance or sometimes drum solos. And this is an example of a fast rhythm here. So that was the Ayoub. Moving on to the next one. It's I'll go over the Maqsoum rhythm. Maqsoum is pretty much the bread and butter of most Egyptian songs or most Arabic songs that we use in belly dancing. It's a fast one. It starts with the dum, and it goes like this. Dum tek tek dum tek dum tek tek dum tek dum tek tek dum tek. Dum tek tek dum tek. So this is Maqsoum, and I'll play an example. This is a fast one. Dum tek tek dum tek 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 dum tek tek dum tek. And another one. Slower. All right, so that was Maqsoum. Moving on to Baladi. What we call Baladi, but a lot of people from the Middle East called it Masmoudi, Masmoudi saghir, or short Masmoudi. So it's a shorter version of a longer rhythm that's called Masmoudi. But this is a short Masmoudi, Masmoudi saghir, or Baladi. And this starts with two dums, so we go into the two dums category. And this goes like this. Dum dum tek dum tek dum dum tek dum tek dum dum tek dum tek dum dum tek dum tek. And I'll give you an example here. It's a classical song. Dum dum tek dum. Alright, next one is Masmoudi kabir, or long Masmoudi. This is a slow rhythm. It's a long and slow one. And it goes like this. Dum, dum, tek, dum, tek, tek, dum, dum, tek, dum, tek, tek, dum, dum, tek, dum, tek, tek. And sometimes it starts with three dums instead of two. Okay, so I'll give you an example here. Dum dum tek dum tek tek dum dum tek dum tek tek dum dum tek dum tek tek dum dum tek dum tek tek. As I said, sometimes the drummers skip a tek or a ka or and replace it with a pause or with some embellishment. So that's why we have to really listen to where the dums are, and that will give us the correct rhythm. I'll try another one. This is a real song, and you'll hear here. You'll hear in this song three dums in the beginning, in the first phrase, and then only two dums. Let's see. Dum, 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 dum. Dum, 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 tek, dum, tek, tek, dum. Dum dum tek dum tek tek dum dum tek dum tek tek. All right, so this had the three dooms, a little tricky, but the placement of the second doom tells you what the rhythm is. All right, so in time you'll get a musical ear and you'll be able to recognize the different rhythms. And as I said, it's important for us to recognize them to know what kind of moves to do. And in the next couple of videos, I'll probably go over some of these rhythms more in depth, and I will demonstrate some of the moves that you could do with these Arabic rhythms. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I will actually write down in the description box some resources, so I'll give you the link to some free online resources to these Arabic rhythms if you like to more know about them and to learn about them. Yeah, please go over them, because what I did here is just a very, very fast introduction. There is way more to this. And listen for examples of the songs or of the rhythms, so you can recognize them in the actual dance songs. All right, so I hope you liked it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you next time. Until then, shimmy shimmy.